my mama lived. But those for us, this ain't for me. I ain't never had ill intent. I do what it takes.
It's week 6 of the NFL, and we'll see the Cowboys, reigning league MVP. He's coming off a nice week throwing the ball. 4 touchdown throws. It's the Cowboys and the Bengals on EA Sports.
From the banks of the Ohio River, there's a look at what's now known as Paycor Stadium here in Cincinnati. Today, we've got a Week 6 matchup for you here, as it'll be the Dallas Cowboys taking on the Cincinnati Bengals.
Again, everyone, I'm Brandon Gunn. To my left, Charles Davis. And Charles, you focus on this Bengal team entering play. They've been playing their best football of the year, winners of 4 in a row.
And going back through the tape, I thought they looked pretty good last week. It was a solid win.
And out now come the Cowboys. First down, they'll start out with Singletary, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. A look there at his numbers on the ground a week ago. North of 100 yards, the 2 scores, and, you know, you got to give a lot of credit to the O-line. We talked a lot about him, but offensive line was good, too.
They're obviously in sync with each other, whether it's zone blocking, power running game, no matter what. He understands how to read them and find the creases that they provide.
Rush coming, and he's taken down.
Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
And this is what you've got to do against a quarterback like him. You've got to keep him in the pocket and not let him get to the perimeter, because once he gets outside, that's where he can really hurt you.
And a nickel look here for the Bengals as they try to defend this on third. They'll drop to throw. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went 3 and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys a little bit jumpy.
You do.
Oh, you understand the same way. Just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went 3 and out.
And now they have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go 3 and out. I went 3 and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here.
So, Charles, you look at this offense. So what a start to the season. 5 wins without a loss. When do you think that you start believing that maybe you're in the midst of something special?
Well, you and I both know every head coach never wants that thought to creep into a locker room. But the truth of the matter is, not quite at this time, because if we look at the Steelers in 2020, they're a great example. Remember, they started 11-0, then lost 5 of 6 and went out in the first round. But I think if you get toward mid-November, the Thanksgiving time frame, and you're still doing this, that's when things start to get real for a ball club.
And he'll grab a gain of 5 out of this up to the 41-yard line.
Well, this defense for the Bengals, they were very strong last week in that win over Cleveland.
And every defensive team that we talk to, they spend a lot of time talking about creating turnovers. And anytime you get 2 or more in a game, you've had a really good performance. They exceeded that number in a huge way. They got the football back 4 times in the win.
And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Start of the second quarter, and it's the Cowboys in possession as they've got it with a 1st and 10.
Singletary. And he'll follow his blockers there all the way down to the 23-yard line.
Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
On first down, they stick with Singletary. It's a six-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
Consecutive positive runs for him on the last two snaps. He certainly appears to be trying to put the offense on his back and just move them down the field when his number is called. The way he's running it, I keep going back to him.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Touchdown! Brandon Cooks. His second touchdown on the season.
And the Cowboys are within an extra point of tying up this ball game.
Man, he just ran a terrific route. Extremely hard to defend when it's run that precisely and the ball's delivered that accurately.
Their quarterback in this offense heading back out to the field.
They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
It's Logan Wilson there to bring him down.
We've hit the two-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. They had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. Looking to throw.
He'll get this out wide to Singletary.
A very good move, but for a relatively modest gain out near the 32. Call it a gain of six on the play. And this will wind up being a third and three. He'll look to throw. That is caught.
And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved. Call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch. First. There he goes, Amari Cooper. Touchdown, Cowboys. 57 yards.
And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half.
And a little time left on the clock, so on the other side, they're thinking, gosh, we'd like to get that lead right back.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Here I am going ahead and tapping out the first half.
Well,
there's still time. They've got to make a decision about what they want to do on the kickoff, whether they want to let their return guy touch it.
Out is their quarterback with this offense to take over once more. He's thrown touchdown passes on his last two drives as he begins here, first and 10.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And that one incomplete, but now a penalty flag coming in late. That might be P.I. Trying to cover Cooper there a little too closely.
And he's such a tough cover because he runs his routes so well. Hard to stay with him and hard to figure out exactly where the break points are. And in this case, he created another pass interference call.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And he's got his receiver, Cooper. Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Those are the kinds of plays right there that show you why he's the number three man in the NFL in terms of receiving yards.
Also tells you there's a full combination of what he's got going in his game. You name it, from route running to catching the football. That's why he's able to produce those types of numbers.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Right up to that point, I was about to say he's had a pretty good half catching the football, but let's just be honest about it. He should have caught that one.
And he knows that. That was one right in his breadbasket and one he normally catches. Eluding the pressure right. This throw incomplete, nearly picked off. And with his pedigree, he doesn't drop many of those. With third down coming up.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
The Cowboy offense set to go to begin this third quarter. This offense ready for the first drive of the third quarter. Well, quarters number one and two entertaining. We saw some good offense points put up, Charles, and all tied on the scoreboard.
And it sets us up for what could be a really fun second half, because we've seen both sides score almost at will here in the first half. And now, here in the second half, getting the ball first, you've got to think, hey, we can go out and really run our offense the way we did in the first half. But if I'm a defensive player, all I'm thinking is, can I make a play to really help out my team and break this streak of offense?
4 yards the pickup, first down.
Let's face it, when you have a guy who can pick up those types of runs and keep the chains moving or stay ahead of the chains, you're making everyone else on offense happy, because you're opening things up to allow for a whole lot of different play calls.
Singletary again. Room here to run. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. 75 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Even from up here in the booth, the play-by-play guy could tell that there was some pretty good blocking on the right side of the line.
Well, you have good eyes, and it's almost like a ballet when it's executed that well. Everyone in the right spot, everyone in sync, everyone hitting the perfect notes. A little more percussion and a lot more bass, I would think, than you get your normal ballet. But at the same time, that was well executed.
He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Flushed out right. And this is taken in at the 5. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. That's good for 28 yards.
That's a big league job there, getting out of the pocket, not panicking, and just buying himself some time. Then he made a good, accurate throw to set up first and goal.
And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Devin Singletary, his 8th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Cowboys have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. And he was excellent on that drive. He deserved to be the one to get across the chalk.
Oh, I agree with you totally. A workhorse on the drive. And how about that last decisive run to punch it in?
So here are the Cowboys to take over. Remember, they're riding that 5-game winning streak and right now in the driver's seat in this ball game as well. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And it's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Good yardage there on first down, exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs, keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. They go backwards there 2 yards, and second and one is now 3rd and 3. Now back to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. 8 yards that time, able to take off, and the result is a first down. Down. Singletary trying the left side. And not a lot of daylight. Not really any daylight inside as he's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Brings up second down. We have played three quarters. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Cincinnati. It's the Cowboys with the football. They'll be looking to tack on to their lead as we get set for the fourth. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Back to throw. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down. To throw here. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play. So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. And a pretty good burst right there as he'll take this down to the 33. 103 yards rushing now for the NFL leader coming into this ball game. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now a run with Singletary. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough at run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Down to the 10, and finally wrestled down at the 8-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it. They got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal. The play fake. He'll look to throw. That is caught. It's Cooper for the Cowboy touchdown. A great effort there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cowboys add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is going to extend another week. Well, that's certainly going to bump up the old win probability index because now it's a two-score game here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you're taking me into that deep water now. Win probability index. This game's definitely not over. We're not looking at a half percent or something. It's just two scores. But the way that this team has played, to me, what I've seen, they absolutely deserve to win this game. They've been the better team by far.
So out come the Cowboys now as their offense gets set to take over. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Second and long. Flush to his right. And he'll get this one to Cooper complete. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. On play action, they'll throw, sliding out of the pocket. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Boy, that ball's just hanging up there waiting to be intercepted. That looked doomed from the start, but they took the deep shot anyway, and fortunately, it winds up incomplete.
Completes it right side to Cooper. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with 65 seconds remaining. They go play action here on first down. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown.
And this is obviously quite a performance. And most of the time when we talk about someone putting a team on their back, I think we're talking about a guy who runs the football. In this case, it's a guy out wide catching it, and he's done exactly that, truly leading his team right now towards victory.
Three touchdown catches. He's been the headliner. Gets set to take the field. Now a play fake here on first down. They'll roll him out right. Oh, a dangerous pass there, and it's intercepted. Escapes the defender. And the Bengals are going to take possession as they've got it at the 42-yard line.
The first down pass, intercepted.
Dallas offense set for this next drive. And here come the whistles and a timeout with 7 seconds left. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And this nearly an interception, but it's incomplete. Well, a turnover really would have helped him there, but not to be. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. He's going to look end zone here for Cooper. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Well, this was a very close ball game at halftime, Charles, but in the second half, that offense kind of kicked things into another gear, and they were able to pull away for the victory.
And, Brandon, I think they're the type of team that just looked in the mirror and said, hey, ton of pressure on, but we're the type of team that can flat out handle it. They stood up with confidence, and made it happen for a victory.
So for the Cowboys, they remain as hot as anyone, 6-0 now through the first month and a half. And they'll get another road.
Sometimes they call me Lucifer. Talk about you do this and that. Ain't none of that new to us. Looking like that, you pop off.